Question for node 3. So node 3 is I equal to 3. So if I write down the node equation for node 3, I'll get use of 4 minus 2, use of 3 plus use of 2. So I'm substituting the value of I equal to 3 in my equation, divided by delta R square plus 1 by R of 3 now. This is the value of R at the third node. Use of 4 minus use of 3 divided by delta R minus use of I, which is use of 3 divided by R of I, which is R of 3 square equal to 0. Now let me substitute the values which I know. I know delta R is 1.5. R of 3 is the value of R at node 3, which is 5. So I'll say use of 4 minus 2 use of 3 plus use of 2. Divided by delta R, which is 1.5 square, plus 1 by R of 3, which is 5, use of 4 minus use of 3 divided by 1.5, because that's the value of delta R, minus use of 3 divided by the value of R square at that particular point, which is 5, and equal to 0. So I'm going to bring the terms of use of 2 together, use of 3 together, use of 4 together, because those three unknowns in this equation. And this is what I get. I get 0.4444 use of 2 minus 1.0622 use of 3 plus 0.57778 use of 3 equal to 0. That's by combining all the terms which correspond to use of 2, use of 3, and use of 4. So that gives me the third equation. So I'm seeing here that I have four nodes, and I want to be able to develop this display and this U profile, the profile for the dependent variable U. And I already have three equations, and the fourth equation will be at node 4. So node 4, I'm not going to write down the differential equation at node 4. I'm going to just write down I equal to 4, and I already know what use of 4 is. Use of 4 is nothing but the value of U at 6.5, and that turns out to be equal to 0.003. So that's my fourth equation. So now I have, as you can see, I have four equations, four unknowns, so I should be able to write them up. And if I write them in the matrix form, this is what I'm going to get. I'm going to get use of 1, use of 2, use of 3, use of 4. These are the four unknowns which I have, which I set them up in the matrix form. Now, the first equation will be 1, 0, 0, because that's simply use of 1 equal to 0.008. Now, the next equation will be obtained from those finite difference approximations which I did. So, I get 0.444444 here, minus 1.1610 here, and 0.63492 here, and then a 0 here. Then the next one is also coming from the finite difference approximations which I use, and this is what I get here. And then the last one is simply that use of 4 is equal to 0, so there will be 0001 here. And this one is 0, and this one is 0. That's from the finite difference approximations of the approximation of the second order differential equation. And this one is coming from the boundary condition, that is 0.003. So you have four equations, four unknowns. One of the things which you got to realize about these four equations, four unknowns, that this particular coefficient matrix, it is tri-diagonal. So that's something which you can look at as homework, that what does it mean that this particular coefficient matrix is tri-diagonal. And also, this is diagonally dominant. The coefficient matrix is diagonally dominant. What are the implications of that? One of the implications of it being diagonally dominant is that if I use some kind of iterative method such as Gauss-Seidel method to solve these equations, that convergence is guaranteed. What is the implication of the tri-diagonal method is that, hey, if you use Thomas's algorithm, something called Thomas's algorithm, you'll be able to quickly solve this set of equations by using his algorithm. Now, anyway, we solved these four equations, four unknowns, and this is what we got. We got use of 1 equal to 0.008. We got use of 2 equal to 0.05128. Use of 3 is equal to 0.003778. And we got use of 4 equal to 0.003. That's what we obtained from solving these four equations for unknowns. So now we have a profile, because we have a profile of how u is behaving as a function of r. So if I was going to plot it, I have r here, I have u here. I know the value at 2 and 6.5 because those were the boundary values which are given to me. So at 2, it is 0.008. At this point, it is 0.005128. At this point, it is 0.003778. And at this point, it is 0.003. So that's the profile which you are getting for your dependent variable u. And now if you want to do interpolation and things like that, you can calculate the value of u at any other point which is of interest to you. Now the exact value for this particular problem, the exact solution to this particular problem comes from the fact that u is of this particular form. You can show that if you take the original ordinary differential equation, you can show that, hey, this is the original form for the, is the exact solution for the original ordinary differential equation. So the way you find out C1 and C2 is because you know that u at 2 is 0.008, and you know that u at 6.5 is 0.003. So those are the two boundary conditions which are given to you. So you can set up two equations, two unknowns. And for this particular case, you're going to get u is equal to 9.1503 times 10 to the power minus 5 r plus 0.015634 divided by r. So that's how you'll be able to calculate what the exact values are for the dependent variable u for this particular ordinary differential equation. So the reason why I picked up this ordinary differential equation is twofold. One is that an exact solution is available, and the second one is that this particular ordinary differential equation actually is an applied ordinary differential equation for the case of thick pressure vessels. So if you have a thick pressure vessel, the displacement is given by that ordinary differential equation which I wrote in the beginning of this segment. Now what we get is that we get u at 3.5. I get 0.0047871, and u at 5 turns out to be 0.0035843. These are the exact values which I get from that particular equation. And the amount of difference which I see is, in this case here, I see 6.65% absolute relative true error. And I see a relative true error for the value at 5 to be 5.11%. So those are the differences which I get for this particular problem. And what I would like you to do is, there's some parts of the homework which I would like you to do for this particular case. One is, I would like you to use this particular formula. Du by dr is approximately equal to u sub I plus 1 minus u sub I minus 1 divided by 2 delta r. So rather than using the forward divide difference approximation for du by dr, I would like you to use this approximation, which is the central divide difference approximation. And you will find out that you'll get more accurate answers for this, because both the approximation for the second derivative and the first derivative both have the order of accuracy of delta r square. So that's the one. And the second one I would like you to do is redo the problem with 7 nodes and see if it increases the accuracy which you get for your solution. And that's the end of this segment.